In case a chi-square test of independence turns out to be significant, it is of interest to the researcher which cell of the contingency table caused the test to be significant. That's why we do post-hoc testing. In essence, each combination of your two variables will more or less show a deviation from the expected count under the assumption of independence. There are several ways to go about post-hoc testing. I'll show only one that I think is already sufficient. First, I request the standardized residuals from the chi-square test of independence. Greater residuals represent a larger deviation, but more on that later. For that, I use the chi-square.test function on my already created contingency table called CT. I add the $ and STDRES and run this line. Second, I will need to adjust my alpha level, since I do multiple tests and need to avoid the alpha error inflation. The easiest and most restrictive form is the Bonferroni correction, which divides your alpha by the number of tests. In my case, alpha is 0.05 and I have 6 tests. Because my contingency table has 2 columns and 3 rows, which, multiplied with each other, makes 6 cells or 6 tests. You can go fancy and use the code shown or simply divide 0.05 by the number of cells you have in your table. Either way, your adjusted alpha comes into play next. Use the qNorm function with the halved adjusted p-value. Technically speaking, the return of this function is the value of the inverse cumulative density function of the normal distribution. Normal distribution because it is used as an approximation for chi-square testing. This number, -2.64 in my case, is the critical value. The standardized residuals now have to be compared against this critical value. Negative values need to be smaller than the critical value, and positive value need to be larger than the positive critical value, 2.64 in my case. In my example, neither any positive residual is larger than 2.64, or any negative residual is smaller than -2.64. Despite the chi-square test being significant, if I do post-hoc testing and control for alpha error inflation, I cannot observe any differences between observed and expected counts under the assumption of independence. That, however, is not a contradiction, and the internet is full of discussions about this phenomenon of significant tests and non-significant post-hoc tests. Just keep in mind that a p-value to which it all boils down to, even when using z-scores, is a function of sample size, which decreases with an increase in sample size for any effect size that is different from zero. So a non-significant test result in almost all cases tells you you're lacking statistical power as a result of too small of a sample. After doing a chi-square test and post-hoc tests, you need to write up the results, which is shown in the following video.